Opinions expressed on this radio program do not necessarily reflect the views of this radio station.
Todd, I'll love it. Todd, I'll love it.
Todd and Craig, good to hear you guys.
Todd, I'll love it.
This is attorney Todd L. Levitt.
Honestly, you could not be any more spot on.
Now, from the Black Diamond Group mothership in the studios of 98.5 UPS, the Todd L. Levitt Law Show.
Welcome to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. Good morning, good evening, and good night, and a Merry Christmas. I am yours truly, attorney Todd L. Levitt, broadcasting and podcasting in a Black Diamond Group mothership in a beautiful green nutrient field in the middle of the Mitten with my good friend, Craig Russell, the muscle, the hustle, the dankiest, dank-to-dank, gassiest human I know, the most overmodulated human on planet Earth. I learned a new word there, folks. You got to love them. The water's wet. The sky is blue. Craig Russell, you are the Fred Astaire of our generation. What say you? How you doing, Craig? And Merry Christmas to one and all.
Merry Christmas, Todd. Craig's not here. It's Santa Claus.
You know, the closest thing I have to playing Santa Claus would probably be big hair.
Now, I would agree with that.
He doesn't have the gut for it, but he's got gray hair. He's not a big guy. He's actually in quite great shape right now. But Craig, hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, Todd. It's tomorrow. It's the Christmas Eve show.
Yes.
Which means we're going to talk about some Christmas Eve stuff. Plus, we also got special guests and a whole lot of other fun things. How was your week this week, Todd?
My week was frickin' fantastic. I dodged a flock of seagulls that were flying overhead. Okay. I love the group, the Flock of Seagulls.
I was going to say, and did you ran so far away?
Yeah, that's a great song, by the way. But you know, I used to be a lifeguard back in the day at Kensington Metro Park.
Of course, you did.
Of course, no, I was.
You've done everything, Todd. You've done everything.
Well, you know, it takes a lot to get to what your dreams and goals and aspirations are. And so, yeah, I had a lot of different jobs. But my point is, I can't tell you how often a seagull flying overhead would, drop something on my noggin. But literally dodged a flock of seagulls today. And it was unbelievable. Nothing hit me, though. So I was happy about that.
Hey, at least it wasn't Santa and his reindeers dropping something out of the reindeer, you know?
I mean, it could have been.
That would have been a little different.
See, that's something I could never figure out growing up because we did not have a fireplace. I loved Santa Claus.
But how did he get in the house?
Well, that was the whole thing.
Didn't have a fireplace. Didn't have a chimney to go down.
I don't know. I think I was told through the milk chute, maybe?
You do realize at this point it's already Christmas Eve, so in other places in the world it's already Christmas Day, so Santa's already flying. He's listening to the podcast, and he's flying at the same time. You know, maybe he's going to stop and, you know, pick up some product somewhere on his way. You know, that keeps him young and fit.
Yeah. What, were you good last year?
I was very good last year.
Come on.
I was very
good. Come on,
Craig. I've been very good.
Not a chance.
As far as you know. As far
as you know. I called you collect because I was jammed up somewhere, and you said, Todd, who to the operator? So in my book, that's a, what do you mean, Todd, who? How many Todds do you know? Now, actually, I can't recall the last time. I don't even recall when I had a home phone somebody could call me collect.
Let alone when was the last time you made a collect call? What is this, 1992?
Right.
10-10-3-2-1. Save yourself money on long distance.
Well, that was that we talked about pagers last week.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Someone would page you, but you, how are you supposed to call them? You didn't have a phone.
Yeah. Well, you know, hopefully you like friends. You just hung out and they had a phone you could use that, you know, because it's a business, but they have a phone you can just hang out and use.
So pagers were great. So if you were somewhere with a group of people and you wanted to like bug out, you would tell somebody, look, can you go call me from that dorm phone or apartment phone and let my pager go off and 911 me?
That's a great excuse. I mean, it's a great excuse.
How many of us out there didn't do that? I'm raising both my arms and both my legs. You know, you wanted to bug out. So you, my God, 911, I got to go. Craig just got pulled over. I got to go. But Craig, huge show. We opened up the show with one of my all time favorite singers, rock and roll singers, just amazing human. Corey Taylor, everybody.
Yes.
Slipknot, Stone Sour. Love Corey Taylor. That song, man, he's got that solid, real pure rock and roll voice, Craig.
Yeah, there's only a few, and he's got it.
I mean, he's Slipknot, Stone Sour, you know. I mean, I think Stone Sour started off in the 90s. Not Stone Sour, excuse me. Slipknot started off in the 90s.
I think you're right.
And then, you know, he had Stone Sour and whatnot. But, Craig, this is one of the last shows of the year. I mean, it is almost. We have one more show of the year here.
That's correct.
Going into 2024. And by the way, we have a huge show. Mike Messina, who is the general manager of M66 Cannabis Company, which is due to open next Friday, the 29th of December, in the village of Barryton, right there on M20, is going to be on the show today.
And not only that, but there was probably a different song you wanted to open up the show with. I'm pretty sure about this.
Yeah,
in honor of that.
Yes, I want to wish Willie Nelson a happy 90th birthday party.
Yeah.
So without further ado, Craig, a.k.a. Santa Claus at the mall.
Ho, ho, ho.
What? Let's play a little Willie.
Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, just look them in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Now you won't see no sad and teary eye when I get my wings and it's my time to fly.
Call my friends and tell them there's a party, come on by. Now just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, just look them in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die.
You know, I have a better beard than he does as Santa Claus, but I'm going to tell you, he's a legend. 90 years old and he's still doing it. I think I just saw him on TV a couple of weeks ago.
No, he was on last week. There was a 90th birthday special. He's got a couple sons who are great musicians, by the way.
Now, on the other side of that, did you happen to see Barry Manilow was on TV last week?
At the Copa.
Yeah.
Copacabana.
They had a holiday special. The hottest spot north of Havana. He at the Copa. He's 80, but he's had a ton of work done on his face. He barely can move his mouth. It's like he's like got a perma smile on his face, and he can barely move his mouth when he sings. It's
look,
crazy.
I'm not going to tell any other human what they should or should not do.
Agreed.
In regards to cosmetic work, surgery, Botox, but some of these superstars that we grew up with or we've watched in movies, as they have aged, this Botox, their faces look like boulders.
I mean,
it's just like, come on.
Wouldn't you think Barry Manilow has been a superstar for 50 years. He's loaded. He could get somebody to do some better work on him than that stuff. You know, you'd think, wouldn't you?
Would you ever get Botox?
Not a chance.
Well, look, Botox is a good thing for those out there who have migraine headaches.
Yes,
though.
That's true.
It works.
Totally,
no,
totally different.
Listen, we have family members who get migraines. I got migraines as a kid for some reason. I was lucky. I outgrew them at 13 years of age. True story.
Lucky
I mean, it was just horrendous. I mean,
my mom used to get them all the time. Yep.
Yeah, but I don't know. I genetically outgrew them, but I do have very close family members who get migraines. It is excruciating.
Yep.
But Botox helps.
Yeah, very much so. But when it comes to cosmetic stuff, yeah, man, boy, you should obviously Google Barry Manilow. He's only 80.
Come on, Craig. I'm trying to have a good Christmas Eve show here today. I'm thinking of Santa. We had our secret Santa last week in our office, so that was a lot of fun.
Did you? Who did you get?
Who'd I get?
Who was your Jenna? And what'd you get, Jenna?
She got me and I got her. What did I get her?
Yeah.
I mean, there was a max amount of money that you could spend on a secret Santa.
Okay.
I mean, do I really have to tell you?
No, you don't. I just was curious.
I got her a new toothbrush, Craig.
Oh, nice.
Because, nice. I mean, think about it. I'm not going to put you on the spot. Maybe we'll put, general manager of M66 Cannabis Company, Barryton, Michigan, on the spot here. I mean, I renew my toothbrush probably every 3-4 weeks.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
If you get sick, you should get a new someone.
Well, not just that. I mean, if you think about where your toothbrush usually is, it's either in a cabinet somewhere in the bathroom.
Which is where it should be. Should be in the cabinet.
Right.
Sitting out next to the toilet.
I don't want to get into the scientific analysis of what goes on when someone flushes a toilet or there's germs in a bathroom.
Just saying.
But yeah, let's move on to the topic here.
All
so
right,
we're gonna end one of our last shows of 2023, and I want to thank all the listeners. I mean, this is not our last show. We got one more next week.
No, we have one next week. Yep.
Yeah, but I just want to thank everyone. But so we're gonna do a show today. We've invited Mike Messina on, as I mentioned, from the soon to open, actually on the 29th of December, Barryton, Michigan, M66 Cannabis Company, and Mike's gonna be coming on the show on a regular basis talking about the strain. Remember, we used to have Grant G Money on.
Yeah.
Well, now we're going to have Mike on, who's part of the same organization, talking about, the strain of the week. But he's going to come on and talk about what's a good strain to relax with a family, all that tension. Remember Sam Gross was on the show?
Yeah, around the holidays
during the
and
Christmas.
Stuff.
Yeah, what's a holiday strain? So,
so what is Grant G Money too important now? He can't get time to come on the show?
Oh, ouch.
Too much of a big shot now? I'm just kidding. Grant's got a lot of stuff going on, man. He's a busy guy. I get it.
Grant's a father. I mean, come on, Craig.
Yeah, I'm just kidding around, man.
Hey, big shout out, though. I want to wish Merry Christmas to my entire family, all my kids, Grant, Mike's family, your family, all the listeners out there, everyone listening around the world, my cousin, Anthony, and the whole family, all the kids, Jack, Teresa, Anthony, Dad, everybody.
I could wish my kids a Merry Christmas and stuff like that. I could actually say anything about my kids because they never listen. So,
kids don't listen to the show either.
I know, except when they're on it.
Hey, big shout out, by the way, to Mike. Big shout out to Mike out there. I was supposed to play Another One Bites the Dust by Queen for Mike. Sorry, Mike. We'll have to catch you another show or two, but we just didn't have the ability today to do that.
Not today, but hey, speaking of a mic.
But Big Shee's a great guy, though.
Speaking of a mic, we've got Mike Messina lining up in the bullpen ready to go. We'll talk to him on the Todd L. Levitt Law Show next.
This is attorney Todd L. Levitt here to tell you about my favorite one and only, the only one I go to, M66 Cannabis Company Recreational Dispensary right here in the great state of Michigan, central northern Michigan, located at 3023 20 Mile Road, Barryton, Michigan, between Big Rapids and Mount Pleasant, Michigan. M66 Cannabis Company is freaking fantastic, folks, from pipes to edibles to flower, two dozen different strains, the staff. staff, all locally hired, general manager, knowledgeable, community-oriented, family-owned. Be sure to check out M66 Cannabis Company, Barryton, Michigan.
Hey, this is Mike Messina, general manager at M66 Cannabis Company out of Barryton, Michigan, off of M66. And I want to personally invite you down to M66 Cannabis Company to come peruse our wide selection of different products, 18 different strains of flower, 29 different types of cartridges, and so much more. We've got everything that you could possibly need and a very well-trained and compassionate staff there to help you find exactly what you're looking for.
That's M66 Cannabis Company, located at 3023 20 Mile Road. That's 3023 20 Mile Road. My favorite recreational dispensary here in Michigan. Be sure to stop in and tell the folks when you get there you heard it right here on the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. Welcome back to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. Merry, Merry Christmas to one and all. Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, and who else, Craig?
Cupid and Donner and Blitzen.
What was your favorite Christmas cartoon when you were growing up?
Hands down, A Charlie Brown Christmas.
Peanuts. Okay, I wasn't going there.
Hands down.
Mine was Put One Foot in Front of the Other. Remember that? And soon you'll be walking across the floor.
That Frosty
the Snowman.
Frosty the Snowman. Yeah,
I mean,
that was a good one.
Granted,
too.
It's more of a. Was that a Christmas cartoon?
Yeah,
or was that
it
more
still
of
was.
A, yeah.
Yeah,
I
they're,
mean,
not playing, they're, not playing in, they're not playing it in February. It's more of a winter thing, but.
Right, right. Well, we got a special guest.
Yes, we do.
Craig, do the intro.
So, without further ado, from M66 Cannabis Company, it's Mike Messina. Hey!
Mike, Merry Christmas to you and family.
Merry Christmas to the both of you, too. Thank you.
Mike, we've been talking. We used to, you know, Grant, obviously, who's part of the M66 Cannabis Company in Barryton, Michigan, the village of Barryton, Michigan, which, by the way, folks, Barryton is the name Barry, B-A-R-R-Y, with a T-O-N on the end. And for those, I mean, this show is heard all over the world, but for those in Michigan, Barryton sits on M66, which is a north and south highway. If you go north, you will run into M10, which will take you west to Ludington. If you keep going north past M10 to 115, you can go northwest, Cadillac, up to Traverse City, Highway 22, that whole region up there. So the M66 Cannabis Company recreational dispensary is opening on December 29th, which is next Friday, this upcoming Friday, this being, you know, Sunday, Friday. And by the way, guess who's going to be there, Craig?
I would guess you.
I will be there from, you know, open throughout most of the afternoon. You got it. I was invited by Grant and Mike Messina. Mike, thank you for having me there.
Always a pleasure.
So, you know, there's dispensaries are opening, I mean, everywhere. But I think the cool thing about your dispensary that you manage, Mike, is that's about to open. One, there's not another one within, 35 miles?
Roughly like 20, 25 miles.
Right. And how many different strains will M66 be carrying?
Well, in terms of flower, we're going to start off with 18 different strains of flower. We've also got 29 different strains of cartridges, 20 different kinds of edibles. It's a pretty great opening inventory.
Yeah, and that's Friday the 29th, December. So very, very cool. So, Mike, let's talk about now for those who are newbies out there, there's sativa, indica, there's hybrids. What is a very festive strain? What would you recommend that M66, you know, will be carrying?
So for me personally, I find the holidays to be a little bit on the stressful side. I've got a pretty big family and half of them are Italian, so there's always a lot of yelling going on. So I personally, I like, oh, it's pretty bad. It's great, but it's also pretty bad. So I like something that's a little bit more on the even keeled side, puts me in a better mood, but doesn't really like lock me to the couch or make me feel hyperactive. And one of the strains we're going to be carrying at M66 is Zookies. It's a cross of Animal Cookies and super classic Gorilla Glue number 4. It's an even 50-50 hybrid, so it's not going to lock you to the couch like I mentioned, and it's also not going to, you know, make you bounce off the walls either, but it will lift you up just enough to, you know, Uncle Giovanni isn't quite so annoying, so to speak.
Right. So in states where it's legal, and you have a legal right to participate because, this, you know, the show's heard all over the world. Michigan's a rec state, which we really appreciate. Did you hear we played Willie Nelson a moment ago that celebrating his birthday? So should you smoke one strain prior to sitting down with family and then one afterwards after you're all stressed out? Or should Zookie take care of the issue before and after and during?
Before, during, and after, honestly. It's going to put you in a great spot to really want to enjoy a big Christmas dinner. It's also packed with a terpene called caryophyllene, which is really, really good for settling the stomach. So you're not going to feel so awful having consumed 12 pounds of turkey in one sitting. And on top of that, you're going to be nice and mellow and you're just going to be enjoying life.
M66 Cannabis Company opening December 29th. I'm so stoked. It's the only recreational dispensary that I will be visiting to, you know, participate in all the laws that now exist in the state of Michigan. And I'm stoked that you've invited me to the grand opening this upcoming Friday, the 29th. So I'll definitely be there. And the cool thing is it's a family-owned business that hired mostly local people and has a very family, you know, personal touch to the people who are going to be employed there. Is that fair to say?
Oh, absolutely. We did all of our hiring from locals out in Barryton. You know, we have never had a dispensary out there in Barryton up to this point. So we're really looking forward to serving the community out there and providing them with something that they, you know, obviously want and keep them from having to drive that 25, 30 miles round trip just to, you know, get a little bud.
Yeah, I always, whenever I'm heading north to court, I always stop off in Barryton. Guys, and I go say hi to Jack Williams at the gas station there. He's got food and beverages and such a great staff. So the Williams family have given so much back to Barryton. They got the hardware store, got Murphy's Bar, and now pizza, Rob's Towing, Huff's. You know, we got so many great businesses, Papalani's gas station right there. There's just so many great family businesses in the village, and I'm so stoked now that as those who are, you know, going north and south or east and west, you know, from Big Rapids to Mount Pleasant, they don't have to go, they don't have to shop in Big Rapids or Mount Pleasant. They can just stop off right there. What's the address?
Oh, it's going to be 3023 20 Mile Road.
Which is really M66. So, and folks, we're so stoked to have Mike Messina, the general manager, in studio with Craig Russell, the muscle, the hustle, and yours truly, attorney Todd Levitt. Yes, I am an attorney. But Mike, you mentioned Zookie. Give me another strain. What's one of your other favorites?
Well, we're also bringing in another personal favorite of mine, Jet Fuel Gelato. Sounds really, really nice.
Did you say it's a cross of Fuel Gelato? Jet Fuel Gelato?
Yep, Jet Fuel Gelato. So
I love these names. Who comes up with these names?
Well, the parentage kind of gives you the name, honestly. It's a cross of high octane and jet fuel, so jet fuel gelato. High octane has a little bit of gelato in its genetics, where that's where the gelato comes from. It's got a really, really awesome, like, berry citrus flavor with just a little bit of pepper in the background. It's really, really nice for, like, creativity. So if you're the type of person who likes to sit down and journal at the end of the day or do a little bit of writing, it's perfect for that. Great for dealing with depression or fatigue if you're not feeling particularly great in a certain day. A little Jet Fuel gelato in your system is going to put you right back where you need to be.
You know, the great thing about you, Mike, you have so much experience in the industry, and you've hired such a great staff who are so knowledgeable. Now, you know, for someone who is listening to the show and they've been thinking about, you know, trying a strain for the first time, what would you recommend? For instance, obviously, you don't want somebody starting off with a 28%, you know, sativa for the first time, or even taking a certain type of gummy. So what would you recommend for somebody who just wants to take a couple puffs and relax?
So honestly, when it comes to first time or very infrequent users, I always recommend something in the upper teens in terms of THC percentage, and try to find something that has a little bit of CBD in it as well. The CBD in there is going to help sort of mitigate the paranoid feelings that often come from smoking cannabis. It's going to help you feel a little more relaxed. And I also always recommend that folks start with smoking a small amount at a time, either like a bowl or a bong, just so they don't overdo it. Because the point of this is not to smoke yourself to sleep or to smoke yourself into feeling terrible. It's to enjoy it and enjoy the benefits.
Yeah, and we don't want anybody out there, wherever you're listening to the show, you know, to do anything, whether you have a legal right to do it, in excess. Look, you could take medication, prescribed medication, and take too much of it, which you should never abuse. Always take as prescribed. But you don't ever want to, you know, Michigan is a recreational state. It is legal, as it is across the country and so many other states now, and medical. But you should always be careful. Know the boundaries of your own existence, what you can and cannot handle. And don't ever drink and drive. And don't, you know, call somebody, get behind the wheel, especially, you know, all year round. But this is the holiday season. You're going to be out there, you know, partying, visiting people with family and friends. Just take the time to ask somebody to give you a ride home, or stay on somebody's couch. Don't put your life and somebody else's life at risk. I mean, truly, folks. And if you see law enforcement out there, first responders, you know, give them a shout. Wish them Merry Christmas. There's a lot of men and women out there working this holiday weekend who are not with their families. We really appreciate you. By the way, Craig, big shout out to Tall Clark, Deputy Clark of the Isabella County Sheriff's Department. Sheriff Maine does such a great job, as does Brian in the Mecosta County Sheriff's Department. He does such a great job, Mecosta County. We love everyone in Mecosta County Courthouse as well. But, you know, just think about all the people out there working to make sure that you are safe, especially first responders, EMS workers, during this Christmas and New Year season. So if you see somebody on the side of the road or a police officer, slow down, get over to the next lane if possible. Anyhow, Mike, we have to go to break, right, Craig?
Yeah, we do.
And when we come back, we're going to be talking more with the general manager of the soon-to-be-open M66 Cannabis Company in Barryton, Michigan, which I will be at. Thank you for inviting me on Friday the 29th. So I'm pretty stoked about that, Mike. Thank you. Will you have any food out there, by the way? Because I'm a hungry guy.
You know, I hear tell that we're gonna could have a barbecue truck out there that day.
It's so cool. And I heard in the summertime you're actually building a huge deck on a Chippewa River. It's a double deck with music, food, and all that stuff. So we'll have to talk more about that. But anyhow, we got to go to break. So Craig, take us out and then bring us back. This is attorney Todd L. Levitt here to tell you about my favorite one and only, the only one I go to, M66 Cannabis Company Recreational Dispensary, right here in the great state of Michigan, central northern Michigan, located at 3023 20 Mile Road, Barryton, Michigan, between Big Rapids and Mount Pleasant, Michigan. M66 Cannabis Company is freaking fantastic, folks, from pipes to edibles to flower, 24 different strains, the staff, all locally hired, general manager, knowledgeable, community oriented, family owned. Be sure to check out M66 Cannabis Company, Barryton, Michigan.
Hey, this is Mike Messina, general manager at M66 Cannabis Company out of Barryton, Michigan, off of M66. And I want to personally invite you down to M66 Cannabis Company to come peruse our wide selection of different products, 18 different strains of flower, 29 different types of cartridges, and so much more. We've got everything that you could possibly need in a very well-trained and compassionate staff there to help you find exactly what you're looking for.
That's M66 Cannabis Company, located at 3023 20 Mile Road. That's 3023 20 Mile Road. My favorite recreational dispensary here in Michigan. Be sure to stop in and tell the folks when you get there you heard it right here on the Todd L. Levitt Law Show.
Welcome back to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show, turning it and burning it with Stone Sour.
Yeah. Yes. Corey Taylor. Yes. I love Corey Taylor.
One of your faves. One of your faves. And another one of your faves, Mike Messina from the M66 Cannabis Company. Yay, Mike.
Mike. And Merry Christmas to one and all.
Yes, on our Christmas Eve show.
Yeah, absolutely. So hopefully everybody on the way to church is listening to the show. Because, Mike, more people listen to the show on the way to church than the other show on the radio, by the way.
I did not know that.
Including the Amish.
Including the Amish. Big shout out to all the Amish out there.
That's right.
So, Mike, talk a little bit about, seems that the popularity, and this has been going on for a while, into cartridges. People always ask me, Todd, what's a cartridge? So can you explain to the listeners exactly what that is and what it does?
Sure. Yeah. A cartridge is essentially a vaporizer tool that's filled with a product that's called distillate. It's a concentrate. Basically, the cannabis plant is stripped of all of its goodness. So all that lovely THC, CBD, CBN, CBG, all the other alphabet soup. And that is basically boiled down into something called distillate, which is then packed into the cartridge. The cartridge is then either attached to a battery, which heats it up and allows you to inhale the vapor. Or what's really cool now is that disposable cartridges are becoming more and more popular, where you don't even need to go and buy a battery. The cartridge itself is the battery. You use it, you throw it away, you get another one.
Okay, that's great. And for, again, those out there listening for the first time who may be traveling, listening to the show, Sunday morning or on podcast, what's the difference between ingesting an edible compared to, you know, smoking cannabis? What's the difference that it does to your body biologically?
Oh, it's actually, it's incredibly different. So
yeah, please.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting actually. So your stomach, when you digest marijuana, actually converts it into an entirely different cannabinoid. That's very, very similar to THC. It's actually like a, I'll spare you the chemistry, I promise. But basically, it's a different form of THC, which is why the feelings of eating an edible are so much more body-based as opposed to head-based when you're smoking cannabis flower. That combined with the fact that it usually takes most people between 45 minutes to an hour and a half to really feel effects. And also, edibles have a tendency to last a little bit longer as well. The big thing with edibles, though, that I always tell everybody is if you're new to them, make sure that you're taking a very, very small dose to start. I can't emphasize that enough. Somewhere in the 2.5 to 5 milligram range for new people, just to sort of see how you react to it, because a lot of folks get particularly ripped eating edibles compared to smoking the cannabis flower.
Yeah, and you're just tuning in. I'm attorney Todd Levitt with Craig Russell, the Muscle, the Hustle. This is Christmas Eve show. Merry Christmas to everyone around the world. We're talking with Mike Messina, the general manager of the soon-to-be-open Friday the 29th M66 Cannabis Company right there on M66 between Big Rapids and Mount Pleasant, right there in smack dab in the middle of the state. And my favorite PC for sure, guys, for sure. But, Mike, what as far as edibles, do they come in hybrid, sativa, indica, dominant, just like flower? Well, how do they come?
So there are the different array of gummies that's on the shelves right now is pretty amazing. You've got everything from indica sativa hybrid gummies to gummies that are sleep focused, gummies that are activity focused, that have like a little caffeine in them. You've got gummies that have CBN for extra relaxation. You have gummies that are made from pure hash rosin, which means that it's literally just stripping the plant, pressing it, and taking the goodies from it and using that to make gummies. It's amazing the different types of edibles that are on the market right now compared to only a short time ago.
So when somebody comes to a dispensary anywhere in the country or world for the first time, and you know, they check in, they have to show their ID. In Michigan, they have to be 21 or older. What I mean, how do you determine their level of knowledge and make sure that you're selling a product that, you know, is something that they're going to enjoy, as opposed to, like you just said, go home, take too much of something, and it's the first time they're doing it and they have a really bad experience?
Two very, very important things. One is to always ask questions, and two is always to listen. People will easily tell you what they're looking for. Nobody needs to be shy walking into a dispensary if they're very, very new to cannabis. We're here to help everybody. And everybody has to start somewhere. So that's one of the big things that we train our budtenders at M66 to do, is always make sure that you're attentive, paying attention, figure out exactly what the customer is looking for, and then direct them to it and make sure they leave and get home happy.
Yeah, and one thing that I would mention is, because, again, Michigan is a legal state, that's why we're having this conversation, and we're also exercising our First Amendment rights, and this is just a conversation, not a call to action, so there's a difference there, just a conversation. But when you walk into, at least in Michigan, and I'm sure other states, you don't just get to walk in like you're walking into a grocery store and you're on the main floor. You walk into a lobby and it's secure. You cannot get into the main floor where the product is. And often the product isn't even, most of the product is locked away somewhere. But you walk into the lobby. Take us through that process, Mike. How does somebody, when they come into a dispensary, what's the experience like?
So oftentimes when you walk into a dispensary, there's a reception desk there. You have a walk up to it. You show your ID. They scan it for to verify its authenticity, make sure it's not expired. Scanning your ID brings you into a queue. And then when there's available budtender, usually they come to the door, invite you into the sales floor where you can peruse a variety of products, figure out exactly what you're looking for, and get rung up there.
Yeah, and not only can you purchase, for instance, at like M66 Cannabis Company once it's open, but you can go into dispensaries and purchase soft goods. You could purchase glassware, and there's other products as well. There's not just flower and edibles and cartridges, so that's pretty cool. I'm looking forward to being out there for the grand opening on the 29th of December right there in Barryton, Michigan, M66 Cannabis Company. That's so certified and bona fide that you've invited Craig and I to be there. So, you know, maybe I'll see some people I know there. But, Mike, my other question for you is if somebody doesn't have a valid driver's license, as an attorney, you know, I specialize, as everybody knows this, not everybody, but in license restoration. Drunk driving cases is my specialty, but I really specialize in driver's license restoration. And I had a client ask me the other day, Todd, I don't have a photo ID. Am I able to walk into a Michigan dispensary? So will somebody be able to walk into M66 Cannabis Company if they have a suspended or revoked license and get into the back room to make a purchase? Or you just said it has to be a valid, not expired license?
That's a great question.
So the big thing is that you need to have a valid picture ID. Without that picture ID to verify that you are the person who actually owns this license, we wouldn't be able to let you in, sadly. And even if that you did have a license that was even just a day expired, That particular piece of identification has to be valid in order for us to let you in the back. It's never anything personal. It's just what the law states, and we always go above board.
Yeah, it's really important that, you know, these businesses comply with all the rules and regulations and statutes and oversight that is required. It was hard enough to end reefer madness, and there's still a long way to go, especially at the federal level. But, I mean, you did such a great job. We're speaking with who, Craig? From where?
That'd be Mike Messina. He's from M66 Cannabis Company in Barryton.
Recreational Dispensary.
That's right.
Yeah. When is that opening, Mike?
We're going to be open on Friday, December 29th, 10 a.m.
Oh, that's great. What are hours of a dispensary? Like, what are they normal hours, like 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., 7 days a week? What is a normal business hour for a recreational dispensary?
Well, oftentimes those hours are actually regulated by the municipality the dispensary happens to be in. Oftentimes those municipalities feel like dispensaries shouldn't be open for longer than, say, 10 to 12 hours a day. Other municipalities are different. They have sort of like a more laissez-faire attitude about it. It sort of depends on where you are.
What I love about Barryton, the village of Barryton, folks, is also, besides the good folks who, you know, live and work there, but you can go and stop off at the park, go to Williams Cafe, get some ice cream, you know, when ice cream is available, and also fill up your water with water jugs, right, Mike? What else do they have there in Barryton?
Yeah, believe it or not, there's actually an artesian well out here in Barryton, and a lot of folks on their way north or south stop off there to pick up a jug or two of water on their way home.
Yeah, so cool. Very cool. You know what I think is really certified is that Ice Mountain is pulled out of the Mother Earth right there in Everett and Stanwood, right off of 131. So I always support Ice Mountain products because I know so many great men and women who work at Ice Mountain there. So big shout out to Ice Mountain for sure. Mike, I was driving up and down M66 on my way to Cadillac Court. I had to go to Lake City. Then I actually deviated over to J Sporting Goods to buy some product there to exercise my rights. Who did your signs at M66 Cannabis Company? Because they are just beautiful around the building and out on the highway there. Who did your signs?
That was actually Signorama out of Troy, Michigan that put those signs up for us.
Yeah, I have some friends that have also purchased signs for their businesses from Signorama. Actually, Steve is one of the installers with Facility. My buddy Steve, he does such a great job for the owner, Bob, over there at Signorama. But is that who came out and did yours at M66 Cannabis Company? Steve and Facility?
Exactly that, yep.
Is that right? They really did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I was wondering who did that, because Renee does such a great job over there also. She's the project director. Well, you know her as well. I've had a few clients I've referred over to Signorama. But anyhow, we have to go to break, Craig. And what segment are we going to, Craig? Because I'm just thinking of Santa Claus, and I promise I will not drink the milk and eat the cookies if you invite me over your house. I'm just saying.
Please don't. Please don't. We're getting ready to wrap the show up after this.
This is attorney Todd L. Levitt here to tell you about my favorite one and only, the only one I go to, M66 Cannabis Company Recreational Dispensary right here in the great state of Michigan, central northern Michigan, located at 3023 20 Mile Road, Barryton, Michigan, between Big Rapids and Mount Pleasant, Michigan. M66 Cannabis Company is freaking fantastic, folks, from pipes to edibles to flower, 24 different strains, the staff, all locally hired, general manager, knowledgeable, community oriented, family owned. Be sure to check out M66 Cannabis Company, Barryton, Michigan.
Hey, this is Mike Messina, general manager at M66 Cannabis Company out of Barryton, Michigan, off of M66. And I want to personally invite you down to M66 Cannabis Company to come peruse our wide selection of different products, 18 different strains of flower, 29 different types of cartridges, and so much more. We've got everything that you could possibly need and a very well-trained and compassionate staff there to help you find exactly what you're looking for.
That's M66 Cannabis Company, located at 3023 20 Mile Road. That's 3023 20 Mile Road. My favorite recreational dispensary here in Michigan. Be sure to stop in and tell the folks when you get there you heard it right here on the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. Welcome back to the Todd and Levitt Law Show. Toking it and smoking it, turning it and burning it with a Zookie on Christmas Day or Christmas Eve. Tomorrow is Christmas. I want to wish everyone in my family, all my kids, and Jen and everybody, a very happy, merry Christmas, safe travels, and you, Mr. Mike Messina, and Craig Russell, to you and all your family and friends.
Anybody you want to say hey, Merry Christmas to you there, Mike?
Oh, absolutely. I'd love to say Merry Christmas to my folks, my lovely girlfriend, Elizabeth, my brother, Joe, and my best friend, Caleb.
Very cool. Yeah, big shout to Caleb. Is that the same Caleb I know?
As a matter of fact, it is, yeah.
Okay. Nothing but love for Caleb, Micah, and family. Total love for them. Tell them I said hi. Also, Mike, this is too long of a conversation, but you are a chef, like Chef Ramsay, right? Are you not a trained chef?
Yeah, I started cooking when I was about 15 years old. Started off as a dishwasher until some line cook showed up a little drunk one day, and then I became a cook. And basically cooked all the way up until the pandemic. And then from there, you know, like a lot of folks at that time, life kind of got flipped, turned, and changed up a little bit and ended up in the cannabis industry.
Yeah, and you're so knowledgeable. We definitely want you back on a show on a regular basis to provide the listeners with some of the new strains. And where do they come up with these names of strains? Because I always can you at M66 Cannabis Company, which would you, is opening next Friday or Friday coming up the 29th there. And I'm stoked because I'm going to be there all day. Can you come up with a Craig Russell, the muscle, the hustle strain? And what would that look like? What would that feel like?
Well, man, I don't know. I don't know Craig too terribly well, but he sounds like a real strong fella. So he probably wants something that's pretty diesel-y, throwing maybe a little sour diesel into the mix. And then, well, you sound pretty sweet to me, Craig. So maybe a little blueberry in there too. And you know, we just created blueberry diesel. We just brought it back from the dead.
Nice. Mike, you have to know, I'm not only am I danky, I'm gassy too. So
yeah.
take that into consideration.
Mike, you're the perfect person. Can you talk, just briefly explain, when I open up the show and I say, Craig is the gassiest human I know, what am I referring to in regards to the cannabis plant when I say that?
When somebody says that that cannabis is gassy, it has a very, very strong odor attached to it. And that's usually achieved, from the terpenes that are in the plant. And also the quality of the cure has a lot to do with the strength of it. When you pop a jar of a real gassy cannabis, you can smell it from two rooms away.
Yep. Fantastic. Hey, I want to, you know, congratulate the residents of the village of Barryton, Michigan. You finally have your recreational dispensary opening Friday, the 29th of December, right there on M66. M66 Cannabis Company. Fantastic. Mike Messina, general manager, you know, thank you for being here on the show. We really appreciate it and wish you and your family a happy, healthy Christmas and happy new year.
Thank you so much, Todd. Craig, it was a pleasure to be here. Thanks so much for having me.
Yep, thanks, we'll see you again down the road, Mike. You'll be back, right?
Oh, of course. Anytime you guys want me on, I'm here.
Love it. Craig.
There we go. Mike Messina.
Mike Messina, everybody.
Good job. Yeah.
He's so knowledgeable. He was on a show about a year ago with Micah and Caleb. I think it was maybe more than a year ago, actually.
I was going to say, man, if he was, I barely remember what I had for lunch yesterday.
If I opened up a recreational dispensary, that's my first round draft pick. He is my Tyreek Hill, J.J. McCarty. You know, he's my guy right there. I mentioned those two. I mean, I love football, but so I was watching Hard Knocks on HBO, so there's where Tyreek Hill came from.
Gotcha.
And, of course, go blue. Gotcha. But, Craig, yeah, I mean, the fact that that company has Mike as their general manager and he hired all their employees, I mean, that's the only place I'm going. I'll drive hours to go to M66 Cannabis Company, hands down.
There you go. Hey, speaking of driving,
what?
Todd?
What, do you want me to drive a sleigh? What, you can't do it tonight? You can't do it, Craig? You promised Mrs. Claus you would do it. What, are you backing out now?
No, the show's over. We got to go.
Craig. Oh, man, Craig. Hey, again, it's a special time of the year, and we want everyone out there, you know, appreciate your family and friends. And
Be safe.
Please be safe.
Please
be safe.
We'll get into more of that next week, the New Year's Eve show, because we really got to beat that one and into people's heads about being
safe. Yeah, that's going to be a huge show.
Yes.
Huge show. Craig, I'm not here for a long time. I so much appreciate you, my friend.
Thank you,
my
brother.
I'm here for a good time. Take us out with a little Corey Taylor.
The Todd L. Levitt Law Show, brought to you by Clark Modular Homes of Mount Pleasant, Rusty Gold Antiques in Everett, Chad Malley Well Drilling of Rosebush, Clear Vision Windows, Siding and Roofing of Midland, and attorney Todd L. Levitt.
Opinions expressed on this radio program do not necessarily reflect the views of this radio station.